Hello guys, welcome to triplelinelearning.com. So in this today session we are going to discuss and learn how to enable virtualization in BIOS. So why we need this one? First of all, that is the question. So let's discuss what is this virtualization. Modern CPU include hardware virtualization features that help accelerate virtual machine created in VirtualBox, VMware, Hyper-V and other RAM. So whenever we are going to create any virtual machine for our lab practice or due to any reason, okay, in our PC, so for that we need to enable this virtualization in our BIOS, okay. So this process is completely same for Windows 7, 8 or 10, whatever your base operating system, that's not a matter. And again, this process need to apply for all VMware workstation version, or whether you are using Oracle VirtualBox also, unless until you will enable the virtualization in your BIOS, that is not going to work for you. You will be able to create the virtual machine, but when you will start the virtual machine, it is not going to run at that time, okay. And regarding these below 2 points, point number 3 and point number 4, so we are going to do it practically. So how you can enable this one means how you will get to know whether the virtualization enable for you in BIOS or not, running the sysinfo.exe command, and then how you can proceed for the enabling that one in BIOS level. While creating virtual machine, it will allow you to create the virtual machine in VMware, but if you are created the machine and when you are doing power on of that virtual machine, you will get this type of screen. Look at here, this host support Intel VTX, but VTX is disabled, okay. So you will get this message. That means definitely you have to enable your virtualization here. Okay, let me show you. Right now I have VMware installed here in my system, so I am just opening the VMware Workstation Pro 16. So I have multiple virtual machine here, so don't be get confused for that. So I am just doing power on of this virtual machine. So I just click here on power on. So you can see I got this message here. This host supported supports Intel VTX, but Intel VTX is disabled. So I have to follow this process. So it is showing here whatever. So we are just going to do that one right now. So I am just clicking on here OK button. Then I am closing this one. Before proceeding for the enabling virtualization in my BIOS label, I just want to show you using the systeminfo.exe command how to check whether my virtualization is enabled or not. So for that I have to just press Windows key button as I show you previously here. I mentioned here. So we have to just press Windows key. Windows key and then R, then I got this box here, so I have to just enter R CMD here. Then I am, after entering CMD, I just click on OK. So in this screen I have to just enter systeminfo.exe, then enter. So now it's collecting all the information about my system. Okay, cool. So we can see here now this last second point, Hyper-V requirement, virtualization enable in firmware, it's showing no. Just look at to my cursor where I have put the cursor. Now it is showing no. So that means virtualization is not enabled at my BIOS level. So I have to now enable the virtualization at my BIOS level. So for that we have to restart our laptop, but before proceeding for that, again it's depend upon on your model how you will go inside the BIOS to do the modification. Open your browser and you have to just enter here BIOS key for your laptop name and model, BIOS key for Lenovo B40, which is my model. So I just enter here, then I got to know here that step 1, press power on button to boot, then press F2 key to enter BIOS setup. Okay, so I'm just going to follow this one right now. So I'm just closing this one. Then I have to go here and just click on restart button. Okay. As my base laptop is going to restart, so I am just switching to mobile mode because that time the screen recording is not possible. So then I am clicking on your restart. So as I know, my BIOS button is F2. So I am just clicking on, once the server will start booting, then I have to click on F2 button. So now I just enter in my BIOS mode. So you can see that. So now mouse functionality is not going to work here. So I just moved to here by using my right arrow in configuration. So in configuration, you can see there is a Intel virtualization technology disabled is there. So I have to make it enable. So to make it enable for me, it is showing that I have to press the Fn plus F5 or F6. So it's depend upon your laptop model again. So I am just pressing here F6 to make it enable. So now we can see it is enabled now. So to save this one, I have to just do Fn and F10. So I am just pressing F10. So it's asking me save exit saving changes. I am just doing yes. The changes is done and my laptop is now booting. So you can see here. Now we will check again whether our virtualization is enabled or not. So for that we are going to repeat once again. Windows button plus R, then CMD, then the command prompt is open now. So system info dot exe, enter. Now it is collecting all the information once again. Great, now you can see that the virtualization enabled in firmware is showing yes. So now it's ready, so we can start our virtual machine. So I'm just double clicking on VMware Workstation Pro. If you want to know how to download and install VMware Workstation 16, so we have another video, link is available in below description. So now you can see that here I have a virtual machine is Ansible Master RHEL8. So now I am just clicking on the power on virtual machine. Now you can see that it will start booting. Previously when I did it, it was not booted and I got that message. So now you can see, let me maximize the screen here. Yes, it is booting. You can see that this. As you can see now, the system is completely booted. Now I am minimizing this one. So to know more on how to create a virtual machine and how to install VMware Workstation, for all these I am putting the link below in description, so you can check on that. So thank you guys, thanks for watching this video. Bye bye.